Last night, that team without star center Rudy Gobert beat the Clippers on a buzzer beater from Joe Johnson. Now, the Clippers trailed for most of the game and shot just under 44% from the field in the second half. Who gets the most blame for last night's loss?
Most all of the time, it's never one guy that gets the blame for a loss. But in the playoffs, you need your stars to be stars. Chris Paul came to play, played very well, did almost everything he could do to try to wield that team a win last night. Blake Griffin had a very good first half, but they're going to need Blake to be aggressive in the fourth quarter. We look at him here. This is the fourth quarter. Look at the lane wide open. All Blake has to do is roll right here. Now he's going to track favors and be able to throw a lob. But since he doesn't, look, you put Chris Paul here with a 6'7 defender on him with nowhere to go. Elbows and boxes are covered. Here we have it again. Blake Griffin have a chance to drive the basketball, use his athleticism. What does he do? Settle for a three-point shot. He wasn't rolling at that time. That's just a tough part of the game. They played Joe Johnson on Blake Griffin. Joe Johnson played shooting guard for most of his career. You can't tell me that Blake can't go down there on a shooting guard and go get a bucket, especially with the game on the line. And he played so well in that first half.
How about this? CP3 and Blake, the two guys you mentioned, they didn't play in the All-Star game this year. They won't be all NBA. What about DeAndre Jordan? On each of those plays, he was actually underneath the basket, kind of clogging the paint. And he can't post up and take advantage of his man either, which leads to my point. They didn't lose. They got beat. That's what happened. The Utah Jazz lost their center at the beginning of the game. And they put in Joe Johnson. They put in Boris Diaw. And all of a sudden, Johnson caught fire. He turned back the hands of time. They couldn't. Look, this is Blake and DeAndre, Mr. Big Shot, on this action. Look, same cast of characters. By Blake over DeAndre. Joe Johnson, by Jamal over DeAndre. There are a lot of people saying he should be all NBA. And I voted him as such. People saying he should be all defense. They're going to need DeAndre Jordan to do more than just catch lobs and get rebounds. They're going to actually need him to be dominant, especially without Gobert on the other side.
That brings up interesting idea. So no Gobert. You got DeAndre and Blake. Utah's going small with Joe Johnson. The Clippers may have to be in a scenario where they say, okay, which one of these guys are playing better? Because we can only play one of them. We got to go a little smaller at that four spot and maybe play Allen Anderson, Wesley Johnson, guys that haven't played that much, but they have to find a way to match up with Joe and Gordon Hayward.
You just exposed a weakness I've been talking about for the Clippers for 5 years, is that they don't have size on the wings. They don't have that 6'6 to 6'8 kind of player that can switch a lot of things, that can help out CP3 on defense, that can take advantage of matchups on the other end. So now you're reaching when you go beyond Bamute to try to find guys' minutes.
But you know who they miss? Austin Rivers. They really miss it. They miss his defensive. He's a very good defender, and he's been very good offensively this year. Now, if you have that guy back, now you can maybe slide a couple of guys down, like you said, with no limp on the ball.
I mean, how big a gut punch, though? I know it's series one, game one, but you're at home. They lose one of their two best players 11 seconds into the game, and you lose?
Well, think about it. Look how good this team and hard this team played at the end of the season the last couple weeks to give it away in 1 minute. They gave home court away in 1 minute. So that's a tough, tough blow.
And plus, their dynamic is turned upside down. I think there's going to be J.J. Redick last season with the team. Anytime Jamal Crawford and Austin Rivers play behind him and make more money than him.
By the way,
salary cap sport.
They need more out of him, too.
Yes, indeed.
You know, I love videos of tantrums. It's one of the things I love most in the world, actually. So why not share this moment here that Chris Paul gave us last night? And I'd like to hear y'all's take on this.
My take is, where's Blake Griffin right now?
Not in the shots.
Well, he gambled on the play and was gone. He was leaking out for cherry picking. But this is frustration right here. Did you talk about a dude that did everything he could
right
in that fourth quarter? He made every big shot, the go-ahead shot. He's getting steals all over the place. I mean, he did everything he could. That's him knowing we just lost this basketball game.
That's him knowing that Blake Griffin went for a steal, never hustled back into the play. I wish we'd have showed the beginning of it. He was frustrated, and he was disappointed by his teammates' lack of effort.
Do you yell in the locker room? Does Doc yell in the locker room? Who yells in the locker room after something like this?
There should be a few of those guys yelling
okay
in the locker room.
More than one human being.
Absolutely.
It's fun to watch. Probably not fun if you're a Clipper.
ISO Joe took him to school.
Ooh. Amazing. Damian Lillard, he averaged a career high in points this year, 27. Chauncey, is he going to have to score even more than that for the Blazers to have a shot?
And I think he will. I mean, he's going to have a tough matchup with Klay Thompson, but he'll get his money.
He's going to represent the O.